and welcome to Just One Question. This is your host, Neelakshi Sengupta. I have with me today Kaizad Kotwal. Kaizad is an Indian producer, director, actor, writer, and designer. And today I'm going to pick his brain about his theatre experience of the 80s Mumbai. Hey Kaizad, you grew up in the 80s India, in the city of Bombay then, not Mumbai. Theatre, cinema, arts were flourishing then. There was no digital world, colour television had just come in, and live performances were a part of social lifestyle. Let's spend some time remembering those nostalgic memories, shall we? Mike is all yours, Kaizad.
I grew up watching a lot of theatre, not just because it was what I liked, but it was a time in which movies were also not so prolific. You got the few foreign films that made it here. Indian cinema was, of course, bursting, and in some ways a lot better in those days, you know, in their honesty and sort of storytelling. There was no internet, and there was, so theater was one of the main forms of entertainment. It's very hard for people today to imagine that that was what people did. And it was an event. You know, you looked forward to it, you got dressed up. You know, it was, you went to dinner after it. It was a very kind of a beautiful thing. And I remember the theater in that day, there was some amazing stuff happening, not again because it was planned that way, but because I think you just had really good people involved. And so I remember some of the best theater I've seen as a young person. One was at the J.B. Pettit School. They had a principal who came in, I think, somewhere in the early 80s, Shirin Darasha, who was very, very pro-arts education. And she developed this team of people who used to put on the JB plays. And Pearl used to sometimes direct those, but they had other directors as well. And they were all original scripts, often written by Dina Mehta. They had a lighting designer who was Arnab Achangandhi. There was another scriptwriter, Kamala Ramchandani. And you know, all these people were involved in putting on these really, really good plays. And the actors were amazing.
What a talented set of people you have interacted with, Kaizad.
It's very sad because in those days, those actors didn't have the opportunities to pursue careers in those fields.
Mm.
Some of the other amazing theatre that was happening back in the day was, believe it or not, by the doctors of Parsi General Hospital.
Really? This is something new. Tell us more, please.
They used to put on an annual fundraiser to raise money for the hospital. And it was all doctors. Of course, Adi Marisban was the sort of, oftentimes the scriptwriter, director of those plays. But to see these doctors perform with no training, nothing, was just brilliant. And you know, so seeing that back then, it gave you an idea that there was talent and the ability. We've just not nurtured it.
That goes to show how creative every individual is. And it does not matter what profession a person chooses. The intrinsic creative qualities develop since school days, isn't it? And that thought triggers another idea. Let's travel back further in time. Tell us about your first experience in the world of theatre.
So my first experience was when I was roughly 4 years old. And there was a costume designer in Mumbai at the time named Roshan Kalapesi. And she had put together this show which was celebrating the sort of various communities in Mumbai, but through their costumes. And so there was, you know, a traditional Maharashtrian family, there was a Parsi family, etc. And I remember playing a young Parsi bacha, I was 4 years old, in a traditional Parsi outfit. So that was my first time on stage. But it wasn't really a play, there was no dialogue.
Hmm.
And then, of course, in St. Mary's, started doing plays that the school put on and found that I enjoyed it. And I remember actually that there was somebody who had come to judge one of those plays, and her name was Havovi Kolsawala, and she happened to be a Trinity College teacher, and I think she liked what I had done and suggested that I train. And so that started my career in training, you know. And at Trinity College, I went to St. Mary's initially, and then I went to Cathedral. You know, theatre was an important part of our upbringing because the schools valued it. It was really kind of nice to grow up with all that theatre.
Which is no longer an important part of the syllabus. Many have pointed that out. Want to share some more interesting anecdotes? We were talking about St. Mary's and school theatre.
And of course, in St. Mary's, the beautiful thing was that all boys. So I remember, you know, some of us wearing gowns and playing the princesses and wearing saris and playing the wives or whatever it was, you know. And that was really nice. I mean, you know, it sort of brought about an awareness and a kind of a tolerance that was not deliberate, but you just enjoyed it, you know. It is beautiful. And then the opposite used to happen when I used to watch the J.B. Pettit plays, because J.B. was a girls' school. And so all their male parts were played by, you know, the young women with fake mustaches and turbans or whatever it was. And so, you know, the school tradition of theatre, English theatre in particular, was very valuable in those days.
That was very cute. But what an age to start theatre. And what a creative way to develop individual personalities of compassion. We definitely need theatre back in schools today. I hope someone is listening and will make the changes that are needed. And how long back was this, Kaizad?
This was a good 30 some years ago. I was a misfit because I wanted to do the arts as a boy. And there really wasn't much. And so the only real place for me to run was to America, because there you have the joys of a liberal arts education, which is what I was made for. And went off to the US. And of course, I went off also with the typical Indian attitude that now we can't do theater as a lifelong thing. So we'll do the practical thing of taking a degree in economics. And because the backup plan always had to be sort of there. The backup plan was really the front plan. Theater was sort of like, we'll do it on the side, you know. And I ended up then pursuing the visual arts.
And I'm so glad that your backup plan became your front plan. Else we may have had a great economist, but we would have lost out on an amazing actor. Thanks for now, Kaizad. I will be back with a new set of queries very soon. Thank you for listening in to Just One Question. Hope you are enjoying this experience. This is Neelakshi Sengupta, and it's time for me to sign out. For now.